TSLP is a molecule that was discovered more than 20 years ago. It is well documented to be involved in allergic phenomena, including atopic dermatitis and asthma. But we've been working on a different aspect of the molecule more recently, in particular, whether it can help the killing of bacterial infections of the skin. My name is Dr. Warren J. Leonard, Chief of the Laboratory of Molecular Immunology and Director of the Immunology Center at the National Heart, Lung, and Blood Institute. TSLP, called thymic stromal lymphopoietin, is expressed at what are called barrier surfaces, so the skin, in the intestine, in the lung. And related to the skin, we wondered, because there are bacterial infections of the skin that can be very severe and life-threatening, whether TSLP might relate to the body's ability to ward off those infections, like methicillin-resistant Staph aureus, also known as MRSA. We looked at the ability of TSLP to increase killing of MRSA in what is called a whole blood assay. We also looked at the ability of TSLP to act with purified neutrophils, because neutrophils are a type of white blood cell known to be important in the killing of MRSA. And we then compared the absence of TSLP versus the presence of TSLP. We found that the plates that had received TSLP had less growth of bacterial colonies, indicating that TSLP had killed or otherwise inhibited the ability of those colonies to grow. It did so in a setting where neutrophils were present. If we depleted of neutrophils, TSLP no longer had the beneficial effect. The discovery is important because it identifies an agent that, at least in these experimental conditions, can help with host defense against bacterial infections. The next steps are to better understand the mechanism of action of TSLP, how it actually signals the neutrophil in order to result in this enhanced killing of MRSA. And moreover, because blocking TSLP or blocking a molecule that helps to mediate the action of TSLP are in clinical use. And so we at least have to think about whether those other therapies, while being beneficial, might have potential effects in limiting the ability to fight certain infections. Staph aureus is a major worldwide problem, whereas we have no clear impression right now that TSLP would ever be a direct therapy. Knowledge from these studies may allow the development of agents that are direct therapies to help host defense against Staph aureus and other infections. So I think that we have learned a number of things that are beneficial, but over time, hopefully will improve therapeutic modalities.